Number 10. The Forest Fenn Treasure. After the millionaire adventurer and art collector Forest Fenn was diagnosed with cancer, he decided to hide a treasure chest containing his most valuable possessions. And as his last days drew nearer, he hid his treasure in the Rocky Mountains. A friend of Fenn claimed that the treasure chest contained heaps of massive gold coins, jewels, gold bracelets, and golden ornaments from South America. Treasure hunters have gone to great lengths to find Fenn's hidden treasure, but still it has never been found, meaning it's still possible for you to go out and find it tomorrow. Number 9. The Nazi Gold in Lake Toplitz, Austria. In the last months of World War II, Nazi officials anxiously dropped large wooden crates into Lake Toplitz in Austria. A few of these containers have been recovered by divers, and they found millions of dollars of fake currency inside them. But many believe that the Nazis also sunk millions of dollars worth of gold, diamonds, and other treasures into Lake Toplitz. And no, there is no relation to Toplitz and Toplitz. The dangers of the lake, however, have taken the lives of treasure-seeking divers. This is because sunken logs near the location of the Nazi treasure reduce visibility and greatly increase a diver's chance of drowning. And as a result, the gold in the lake still has not been recovered. Number 8. A Golden Owl Hidden in France. In 1993, a famous treasure hunt designer hid a golden owl in the French countryside and promised to give 1 million francs to whoever found it. The owner of the gold owl left 11 clues leading to it, but treasure hunters have failed to find the golden owl so far, and the creator of the treasure hunt eventually died in 2009 without revealing the owl's location. However, before he died, he revealed that he had checked to make sure that the owl was still hidden. And while he was looking, he saw evidence of recent digging near the owl's burial site, which means that someone at some point was very close to finding it. Number 7. Lake Guadavida. For thousands of years, as a part of a local tradition, the Muisca people of modern-day Colombia would throw gold into Lake Guadavida to honor their gods. Many believe this lake is the location of El Dorado, and gold has been consistently recovered from this lake. The Spanish first attempted to drain the lake in 1545, but barely lowered the water level of the lake. But even though the Spanish failed, they still uncovered massive amounts of gold. Other attempts to drain the lake have left hundreds of workers dead, and all other attempts to recover the gold from the lake have failed, meaning gold is still under its surface. Off the shores of Nova Scotia is Oak Island, which is an island where riches can be found at the bottom of a pit that treasure hunters have struggled to excavate for hundreds of years. The infamous pit was discovered in 1795 by Daniel McGinnis, who found a massive pit on the island. Later, very strange objects were found, such as coconut shells, which are not native to Oak Island, and a mysterious stone with symbols that have not been decoded. Numerous attempts have been made to dig up the pit, and during these attempts, traces of gold have been found, and other treasures have allegedly been discovered as well. But the finders usually keep their discoveries to themselves. If you suddenly have the desire to find the Oak Island treasure, you're certainly not alone. Even the US President Franklin Delano Roosevelt once searched for the treasures of Oak Island. So if it's out there, you'll find it. Number 5. The Treasure of Lima. After sacking the Incan Empire in the 16th century, the Spanish captured nearly endless amounts of gold and treasures. Much of that wealth was stored in the city of Lima until 1820, when a revolt forced the Spanish to evacuate. The British captain, William Thompson, was put in charge of transporting the treasure out of the city until the revolt was put down. Instead, Thompson and his crew killed the Spanish guards and allegedly buried the mountains of treasure instead. Thompson was later captured and forced to show the Spanish where he had buried the gold. He took the Spanish to Cocos Island, but ran into the jungle, never to be seen again. A Spanish cargo manifest from the era stated that the cargo contained amazing items such as a solid gold, gem-encrusted, life-size portrait of the Virgin Mary, along with 200 chests of jewels, 1,000 diamonds, solid gold crowns, 150 chalices, and hundreds of gold and silver bars. Today, the treasure is estimated to be worth somewhere around $200 million. And its current whereabouts are still unknown. Number 4. The Treasure of San Miguel. Throughout history, the Spanish Empire has had really bad luck with their gold and riches. This becomes very apparent when you learn that in 1712, Spain assembled the most valuable treasure fleet in all of history, only to immediately lose it. The Spanish fleet of 11 ships were all filled with silver, gold, pearls, and jewels, and their cargo has been estimated to be worth about $2 billion in today's money. The Spanish planned to depart from Cuba just before a hurricane season hit, hoping the hurricanes would keep pirates away. Instead, the fleet ironically was wiped out by a storm. The destruction of the treasure fleet cost Spain the lives of countless sailors and massive stockpiles of gold and silver. 7 of the 11 ships from that fleet have been located, but only a tiny fraction of their cargo has been recovered. Historians believe the Spanish vessel, San Miguel, carried the majority of the gold. The only ships from this doomed fleet that divers have found so far were discovered off the coast of Florida. So it's very likely that much of this treasure fleet is still undiscovered. Number 3. Blackbeard's treasure. The famous pirate Blackbeard terrorized the seas for many years, and while raiding merchant ships, he accumulated a massive fortune of stolen gold. But what surprises most is that this now famous pirate's stash of gold is still up for grabs. After his death at sea, the location of the hidden stash of gold was lost. Even though Blackbeard's flagship has been found in Beaufort, North Carolina, treasure hunters aren't any closer to finding his gold. Number 2. Dutch Schultz's hidden fortune. During the 1920s, the crime lord and mobster Dutch Schultz controlled a massive network of organized crime that made millions from bootlegging and racketeering. And as a result, Dutch Schultz amassed a gigantic fortune. But due to his criminal lifestyle, Dutch Schultz's illegal fortune had to be hidden at all times. And some believe he hid his money in the Catskill mountain range. But after Dutch was gunned down by rival mob bosses in 1935, his hidden stash was lost. His still hidden fortune is out there waiting to be claimed, and is estimated to be worth anywhere from $5 to $10 million in today's money. Number 1. Leon Trabuco's gold. The Mexican millionaire Leon Trabuco believed he could take advantage of the Great Depression in the United States to expand his net worth. He was so convinced that the gold prices were going to skyrocket, he bought as much gold as he could to resell in the United States. And in less than 3 months, he and his partners had collected almost 16 tons of gold, which they hoped to smuggle into the United States. And he hired a pilot to make several covert flights into the New Mexico desert. Trabuco never revealed the location and was very careful not to create a map. Unfortunately for Trabuco, the U.S. Gold Act of 1934 made private ownership of gold illegal in the United States, and Trabuco's scheme failed. Over the years, he and his partners all died, and Trabuco took the location of his gold hidden in the Mexican desert to his grave. So out there, somewhere in the vast sands of the New Mexican desert, is millions of dollars worth of gold, just waiting to be claimed. If you want a treasure cove of knowledge, be sure to subscribe if you haven't already. And if you want to hear my voice some more, you can go check out my channel in the description. And we'll see you all next time.